What's up, everyone? Welcome back. Last time we played, I believe, the Commandos, the order I decided to go with. I haven't actually uploaded all the videos and put them together yet, but that's kind of what I decided to do. This time we're going to play the Champion. This is a human champion. This is what Baldur normally looks like in all the cutscenes, so I think that Baldur's supposed to be a human champion, just as a lore perspective character. My headset is going completely nuts right now with a bunch of cracking and popping and movement and stuff like that, so I'm really hoping that's not actually being picked up by the mic, because if it is, then I'm gonna have a very, very irritating time in editing. But hopefully that kinda subsides as we progress through the episode, so let's take a look real quick. So I was talking before about these are the red weapons and stuff like that. The elite weapons are on the wall. You can see all the models for them, cannons, rifles, stuff like that. I hate that sword model, I said it before. The staff model's the one we have, obviously. It's got like some kind of raven eagle looking thing on it. And let's look. I didn't realize I'd died this many times with this character. I have 91 deaths. I actually died 2 times getting to the, what is it, the end of the campaign. So I was actually kind of sad about that. Oh, we have to do cyberspace? Shit. We're probably gonna do that today. We'll do 2 things today. We'll do cyberspace and a level. So let's take a look at the gear. As always, several cool-looking red weapons. Hode actually has a weapon and armor set, and I forgot, or just a weapon set. I forgot to mention this before. On the right side, where it says page 1 of 3, you can actually flip through and see some stuff. And this is a 2-piece weapon set that gives you +1 to your skill tree for human. So you have to be human to use it. I think this is a human only, yeah. And it's a sword and pistols. This is the sword. And I already have the pistols on right here. Arms of the Betrayer. These are Hode's actual pistols from the cutscene, if you could kind of see it. It's easier when you're actually in a cutscene, and it kind of gives you a close-up or whatever. So you have a lot of stuff. This was actually a waste of a rune slot. I don't know why I put that on there. I don't think it came that way. But we have a lot of cool stuff. Necrotized, I think, is the toxic pool. So those can be really good. Azir pistols, you can put whatever you want on them. Usually you want to find some, what's the difference? These are, say, butcher pistols, probably different. What you call it? Graphic or whatever. So yeah. I was saying before, you usually want orange items with no slots. Sometimes you can get like orange items with really good slots. Like you get something like Necrotize, which you normally, I don't think there's an actual rune for it, so you have to get really lucky. And then these are the rifles and stuff you guys have seen, Tears Carbine. I can't remember which one's better, Incinerating Grief. We've seen that model. I have a laser one, right? There it is. Yeah. Okay. The armor, this is the Cybernetic Champion one. It's a frickin' Magneto helmet. But we have some other stuff. I'm going to use, I don't know why I have these. I was probably going to make some out of them, but they don't look that good, so I don't know why I'm actually saving them. So let's see, we're going to use, not these. These gloves are better, because as always, they have a, was it a red rune in them? They're easier gauntlets. And then we're going to use these boots, because they have loot chance. And they still look pretty good with our set. For charms, I was working on a weapon charm for Black Hole. This isn't actually the best one. There's a weapon and armor charm for Black Hole. That's what you want more of, but I only have one. I duped it and I put it on my, what you call it, my bioengineer. Nope, we're not gonna find runes. I don't give a shit. I have a lot of stuff here. I have a lot of stuff here. I didn't clean out my inventory. I should have, but who cares? I don't intend to find anything, and if I do, I'm not gonna use it because I don't really play this game seriously anymore. So let's just head on with our lives. Let's do the level first. I think the level's gonna be more entertaining than freaking cyberspace. Cyberspace is a pain in the ass. So this might be 2 videos. And I'm sure the cyberspace one no one's gonna watch because it's just me running around talking, so I don't really blame you guys. I needed to, okay, I was gonna show the skill tree. So the champion has a pretty cool skill tree. No. I wanted to go here, but it went up too many spaces. So you have like chance to set enemies on fire by meleeing them, increase finisher damage, more fire, Airbase melee attack damage increase, which is pretty good. Sword damage increase, which is pretty good if you decide to use the Betrayer set like we're doing. I went with an air combo champion just right now just to show it off, but let's go with the pistol champion first because I don't like the pistol setup. But I think people still want to see it anyway at some point, so just put one of those. Max these out, pistol damage. Max this out. Max this out because we have slug pistols. I don't have any. Damn it. I have to. There we go. Boop. Boop. Cool. It's funny, we have all this extra damage and it still feels like slug pistols just aren't. Like, they're just not enough. So let's see, we might. Won't fall on that. Definitely want this. Highest DPS. Definitely want this. We're gonna put 8 in here, I think. You see we have plus 2 skill points on the right, so by getting this to 10, we get the free max combo meter. I don't know if you can get to level 5 for combo, I can't remember. I want to say you can, but I'm pretty sure you can't. I don't know why I think you can get to level 5. Whatever, though. Alright, so let's put... Do we need more reload speed? Like, it's just... If we put 3 in here, that's another 7.5%. That's actually kind of fast. It's almost 10. Alright, so we'll do that. Okay. And did I switch my... I'm using the sword, right? Yeah, I am. Like I said, I don't like the pistol champion, so I don't plan to use it that long. So that's why I'm, like, showing it now, and then I'm gonna switch off. So let's just... Actually, we can start a little bit further, can't we? No, let's go through the whole level. So I said I wanted to show what these levels look like when you go through them, not in the campaign aspect or whatever. I don't think this level changes at all. Maybe some different enemies or different placements, but I think it's still goblins and trolls for the most part. So whatever. Yeah, now there are no cutscenes, no intros, stuff like that. This is just if you want to level up, get gear and stuff. Oh, shit. There are enemies here. This isn't just a nice little cutscene anymore. We're pretty slow because we don't have combo meter yet. But since we're human, we're going to build it pretty quick. And here's our spiders, a freaking machine gun turret. I guess I could show off all the specs for champion. I don't plan to use the sword one that much, but I will. You can shoot missiles, I forgot. You can shoot them out of the air. Another reason that makes plasma a really good damage type is because you can shoot one missile and usually blow all of them up. Oh yeah. You see, before there weren't even enemies in here. And now there are, oops. All the troll! Now in here we have to deal with, you know, enemies right away, Polarity enemies, trolls, Polarity trolls, or not Polarity trolls, Polarity goblins with status effects that'll freeze us and shoot us and stuff. It's still kind of hard to pick off the arm, even with pistols. There we go. Yeah, I like the melee champion more. Damn dog. Not stop me, I'm sorry. I didn't have that as a plan. I was thinking, there's one thing I really don't want today. I don't want to get stomped on. So I just decided that that wasn't going to happen. Should be more. Nothing but ghosts here, even though we just had a huge fight in the freaking entrance room. Oh, that's right. We got a battle cry. That'll probably help us out. So pistol champion plays a lot like commando, which is part of the other reason I don't like it. It's like, if you're gonna do this, then just go... And just go commando. And I don't mean the non-underwear type. The other benefit of the toxic pool is that it definitely seems to blow up missiles. Or these ones are glitching out or something like that, but I know it can blow them up. As always, it's better to reload manually than it is to reload automatically. I'm trying to scratch my face, dude. Because they're attacking me. Oh, that didn't last long at all, though. Oh. Oh. I'll see if I can set something up. It'll probably be easier with the air combo champion. Like, you can launch up multiple people and then just use your pistols and shoot all of them, which is pretty funny. But we're at a good spot already. Let's see, we still do a lot of damage, but these are goblins. Goblins die pretty quickly. Pretty sure I just got hit by a freaking combo drainer.
This goblin stuff seems to be powering it. Like they cut into the original circuitry or something.
Yeah, if you ever play this and you're trying to level up and stuff like that, it's definitely better to play the non-campaign versions, just because there are more enemies. So obviously more XP, more enemies, quicker, more fighting, more stuff, better ingredients, better pizza, all that stuff. We haven't seen any elite trolls though, I'm very surprised about that. Just gonna use all the stuff that we have at our disposal. It's actually very good that we got the toxic pool. It's still doing pretty good damage. It's almost comparable to the commando in terms of output. But like the commando, Commando's still more efficient. It's like a couple bullets and it dies, just keep walking. Yeah, when you start playing on higher difficulty or higher levels though, the enemies tend to jump from you more and be more aggressive, more evasive, all that garbage. Okay, he's gonna jump at me. He decided not. Oh, he died. He didn't decide not to do it, he just died. As always, get the toxic pool under the spawn, and you are good to go. We're gonna play some Dark Souls 2 after this. I was bitching about it in the last video, and then last night I was playing. I was actually having some fun with it. Probably because I rerolled. I started playing a knight instead. And knights are a little more forgiving, especially since that game's a. Like. Good 20% or so harder so far. And since you get the better starting equipment, I feel like... Because it's dumb, the Swordmaster, or Swordsman or whatever, you start with two swords, and they're both plus one, so like, they start you off with slightly better stuff. And they're definitely stronger, but you can't... You don't have the stats to dual wield them at the start of the game, which is dumb. I think you can dual wield short swords, but the scimitar, you can't, because you're already at max, like, in terms of the stats. Like, the swordsman starts with 16 dex, and the scimitar needs 16 dex to actually use. I do have a ricochet charm, which would probably be really good for this spec. I'm trying to reload desperately, but I keep having to dodge these guys, and then they keep punching me, and... Damn it. No! Missiles! Yeah, you can see our damage output much, much further away from the commandos. Especially when the enemies take more than a couple of hits to die and you don't get some ricochet. Which is not good. Sometimes this guy's polarity troll? Not this time. He's gonna use all the buffs! Keep forgetting to put up the battle cry. Oh. It's also really hard to hit these arms sometimes for some reason. There we go. It's really get on the side of him. Yeah, so I was playing a knight. It was pretty fun. And I didn't. I did what I was gonna say in the last video, or I wanted to. Sorry, trying to adjust my headset there. Okay. A little more? Alright, I think we're good. So, yeah. I was using a spear. I was looking for a good spear, and I couldn't use something like the Wing Spear, because I found a couple, but then you can also buy it like really quickly, and I think in the Bastille. But I bought the regular spear from that the blacksmith Majul, I forget his name, like Laurentius or Lenturus or something. And I didn't realize how good the base spear was. It's, you know, the one that's just called spear. And you can buy it from him, it's like 1400 souls. And I knew that it was a thrust weapon, obviously, because it's a freaking spear, but it has a strike attack. And strike is the best damage type in Dark Souls 2, I think, because it's like most enemies have the lowest resist to strike. So strike are usually like clubs and maces and stuff like that, so they're not... It's not a common damage type either. You know, most weapons won't have it. And most of the weapons that do have it are heavy weapons or like maces and stuff that are really slow, they don't do too much. You know, in terms of like group control, they're pretty good single target weapons usually. But for some reason the spear has... Its R2 looks like a strike attack because you sweep with it, so I'm pretty sure it's a strike attack. And it gets the same, it gets a sweeping R2 in one hand and two hands, so you always have access to the strike attack. And what's more, is it's so strong even at the beginning of the game. Like, for the night, my normal thrust on a lot of the enemies was doing about 75 to 82 damage, and the R2 strike was doing like 185. I forgot they put a maze in here when you play on the, non-campaign version, so you can already see there are a lot of differences. This little top-down maze. Playing some, NES Zelda. Pretty sure I remember the path through here, but you can always check these out. Because they have spires or whatever if you want to loot stuff. This actually isn't a bad camera angle, surprisingly, for this game. It's not as fun. Pretty good, it gets us through that weak little maze. There's another spire over there. I guess we'll get it for completion's sake, I don't really want it. But let's just show everything. See, I was using the spear. And I was so impressed with how strong it was. Just because it has that extra strike attack, and it's got range obviously, and then it's very safe because you can use it behind a shield. Oh, they're dead. And so far, my knight character hasn't died, so I'm very confident that I'm not going to get the deathless run through, so I can get the ring that hides one of your weapons or whatever. I don't know if it's the same way in First Sin, but in vanilla Dark Souls 2, if you beat the game without dying, you got a ring that hid one of your weapons. So it's kind of like a hidden weapon all the time for one of your hands. And then if you beat the game without using a bonfire, you get the one for the other hand, so one's, you know, left, one's right, obviously. And I've never done that. In vanilla Dark Souls, I haven't gotten either of them. I haven't tried to get either of them either. It's probably easier to get the no bonfire one, because you can actually die, than it is to get the no dying one. The no dying one seems like... To get them both at the same time seems like the best decision to go for, because you're already making the game hard enough. And if you can do one, you can probably do both together. But it seems so difficult sometimes, just in concept. You know, most of the... I don't know why he's attacking his own buddies there. He just is, so I'm not gonna question it. Oh shit. Keep forgetting I have a different... I'm gonna switch specs in a minute, too. I'm not even using the pistol that much. No, they're doing work here. I mean, you have to keep reloading. It's the one thing I don't like about pistols. You have to reload like every 2.5 seconds, basically. So let's switch our build. Let's go to what I wanted to use. I'm not going to use the left-hand side, just because none of this is really impressive. This is just pretty... This would be like playing a one-handed berserker, more or less. And then even then, this doesn't say that it increases damage. I'm pretty sure it increases your damage, though. For, your airborne stuff. So let's go back. This is probably okay. I don't know if I need more. We'll look. This is always a good skill, just more crits. Oh, what? Oh, because I don't have my charms on. Because I'm working on one. That's plus two. Oh, because I have plus two to the human skill tree. That's what it is. Okay, so let's actually go back and... because we're going to switch to our staff, probably, because I feel like the staff's better for this setup. This is our set bonus staff. Okay. Yeah? Okay. By that rationale, I could probably use an actual rifle instead of the two pistols also. Okay, so we have plus one, so we have to go one extra there. Shit, I shouldn't have done that. Let's actually respect this. Because I'm not working on the other charm right now, so I don't need it. So I'll put my other one back on to get my plus skills. Oops. I'm just screwing up in this menu really bad. Yeah, so the spear's been pretty fun to use. I've actually been enjoying First Sin so far. I tried to do some co-op, and I wasn't getting summoned too frequently. Aw, damn it. We have the money to actually burn on this, but we spent quite a bit. I just screwed up again. Alright, I'm gonna actually think about this. I always get a couple here just to let my plus skill charms bring them up a little bit. And then what are we gonna put the rest in? Actually, we can put the rest in this stuff, huh? Can we definitely... do we want this? I think so. The higher they get launched, the more time you have to jump up and actually hit them, and then also I'm pretty sure they take more damage from falling. So it's usually pretty good. So I'm gonna max this out. Just for duration. I guess we'll max this out too. I don't know if this is actually good to max out while we're doing it. I'll probably get some attack speed, because we don't need... I could do four here. I could definitely do four here, because the spider's really good. I think I'll do four there. And then one here. Okay. Alright, there we go. So yeah, I already have a clip from Dark Souls 2 that I'm going to put up, because I did get to do some co-op. I'm not going to pop the wells and stuff, just because we've seen a lot of them. I just kind of want to get through the level quickly. Yeah, we don't need to do it, though. There's no spire back there for loot this time. Alright, here we go. This is our battle cry. It makes it so you can launch anything that you actually hit. Which you could actually... okay. I think it's the exact same one we found, too. On the commando. Yeah, the... what is it? You can actually... this battle cry, all it does is it turns every melee you have into a juggle attack. Which, if you're APM for two human is high enough, you can actually do it manually. You just have to get your double taps in as you slide to things. Which is doable. Definitely doable. There's a dark clarity troll back there, which means we're gonna have to mount it. Gosh, I have to cough. Whew, sorry about that. Okay. I'm going to look for a new graphics card. I'm going to look for RAM. And I'm going to look for a new microphone. Aww, I wasn't thinking. That's what I'm going to start looking for as of tomorrow. Because I don't know why that doesn't stand any longer. I don't know if there's a glitch or something. Actually, you can stand here and just keep slapping them as they come in. The reason I like the staff for the air combo champion is Actually, is that just an elite troll? I guess that's a regular troll. I guess my eyes deceive me. Yeah, they did. Yeah, I'm... Oh, the reason I like the staff is what I was saying. We use our spider to blow off his arm. Just to make life easier. It's one of the benefits of the... Was it the champion? Is it can still do that? We almost got a face full of missiles. That's actually one way I died. They said I died twice in the campaign, that's one of them. I was playing the Ice Forest, and I just ran into a goblin, and just got a face full of missiles, so it was not good. Not that dying has any consequence, but, you know, I have pride. I'm trying to protect my pride. I'm actually not going to go hit that thing or whatever, because the secret rooms don't change, as far as I know. As far as I remember, anyway. Yeah, I want to buy a new microphone, because I'm tired of the headset. That's good. The voice, like I said, the voice quality is really good. But it... Just it sitting on my ears when I talk, my jaw moves because it's got really big head coverings. And if I talk, sometimes it moves and sometimes it, when it pops, it... Oops. It gets picked up by the microphone and it makes a very loud pop sound and I have to go out and edit those in the recording, which is actually pretty easy, but it's a pain in the ass, because you literally, and I'm not over exaggerating this, you have to remove one frame of audio. It's like you find out, you go through the, you know, my talking audio or whatever and find out where it happened, you just listen for it, and then you can zoom in, and then you can find, because you'll see what normal speaking audio looks like, and then you'll see this huge, like, wave, like, a huge spike going through it, and that's what the pop was. And then you delete that. And then it's cool, because instead of having, like, a big pause or whatever, you can actually cover the space by sliding my actual voice audio together after that. And it sounds almost... It honestly sounds pretty normal, and you probably couldn't tell what it was unless I told you. These guys should all die. So, it's still a mine that just blows up and kills everything, but it's pretty fun and interactive because it actually, you can actually combo off it, obviously, and it just looks funny to watch them all go, ah! But yeah, so I'm gonna buy a microphone. I said before, the thing that was stopping me was my video card's super noisy. And you can actually... You can hear it sometimes in the background. If it's like super quiet and you turn up your Sometimes you get like a spawn of like a swarm of guys, not just him. But we got him that time. Yeah, if the game audio is super quiet and I don't turn the voice audio down enough, or if I don't edit to get rid of it, which I had to do a couple times, you can actually hear the graphics card fan. So that's not cool. So once I get a new graphics card, I can get a new mic. There's a human rune, there's a freaking bird. Looks pretty cool. And depending on what level of... You can get to level 5. I'm very confident in that. You should be able to get to level 5 combo. Jump out of this. Maybe you can. I don't know. It's level 3. Level 3 is much easier to hit everything with because it's more of a AoE instead of... You see how the bird like flies away on the level 4? That bird will actually like shoot a laser beam or something, and the laser beam hits stuff. But it's kind of hard to get the camera to show you. But yeah, buying the graphics card and the RAM and the microphone's probably gonna run me like $300, maybe a little more. Man, no one's leaving me alone today. Yeah, is it $300? Maybe more. Probably closer to $400. It's like after I do that, I can't really buy anything for a while. No extra expenditures. Oh, it sucks that we do have to come here to do this stuff. Bleh. Yeah, I've been very appreciative that people have been at least trying to watch this series so far. It's not getting nearly as many hits as Chrono Trigger did, but it's also over the Thanksgiving weekend. So it's probably... It's partly probably because, you know, people are out of town, people are busy, people are doing stuff, but... This Let's Play was more just for me than anyone else. Because this is the game I enjoy, you know, and I knew it wasn't going to be super popular, but, you know, can't deal, or can't ask for everything. See, having all the extra cyberspace powers is how you do all this stuff now. And we're going to use the fire, and the fire's not going to... We're not going to get anything out of here. I think I've gotten red charms before out of this one, though. Not this time. It's always important to make sure you look at them, too.
Knowledge. Nidhogg was created to clean away what we failed to keep alive.
I was talking before that I was gonna have David, my friend, play a couple levels of this with me, but then I remembered that he sold his 360 and all of his games, so we're not gonna be able to actually do that. I'm pretty sad about that, so there will be no co-op to human going on, sadly. I also realize that the series I do that aren't blind Let's Plays tend to not be as popular. Just because I guess people don't want to watch someone play a game that they've already done. Or, you know, that they know really well. Personally, I think it's because no one... Because most of the time, a lot of the comments I get for my blind Let's Plays are people telling me how to play the game. And so, you don't really have that opportunity with this. And so, because of that, there's just less views, less chatter, less comments, stuff like that, just because, you know, now it's not a series that people can tell me how to play and watch and explain things to me, it's me explaining things to them, and people just don't wanna... People don't wanna see that. I think it's because... Oh, that was a good stretch. I'm not saying this about everyone that watches my videos, but I think it's mostly because psychologically people want to be the ones doing the talking. They want to be the ones explaining things. They want to be the ones, because if you have knowledge and you're helping people, you have all the, you know, the power. You're in that position. And when someone's explaining it to you and you're learning and you have to hear them and stuff like that, you're listening, so you're not talking, and people like to talk more than they like to listen. And then, we still can't reach him because they have freaking pistols. Sorry. So yeah, people don't usually want to listen. It's not as fun for them. They don't take it upon themselves to learn something or whatever, so... Oh, we can hit that one. No, but it didn't matter. No! I find that interesting. That's not what I'm accusing anyone of, but that would make the most sense to me. No! Speaking of listening, it's irritating to play Smite with my friends now. Because I started playing with the people I didn't really want to play with, just to have more people involved, and it's been fun. But it's really hard to play Conquest with them, or anything, because they don't... They just don't listen to things, and they don't know the proper times to go in on people. I was explaining that before a little bit. Grendel 2? There's no Grendel 2. Let's pop our battle cry. We should be able to... Damn it. If we get a crit on the finisher with enough bonus damage, we can actually break 100,000. Which is pretty funny. I'm gonna blow all these up. Give me the 100. There's 50, so if it crits, we're gonna get double, I think. Unless that was already a crit, I don't think it was though. No! No! Ouchies! See, there's another one where if you have the damn plasma gun on a commando, you can just shoot Grendel in the face and you'll blow up all of the little bladed guys coming out every, like, as they leave him. Just don't hit me. Get out of the air. Oh, my finisher just didn't even hit. Screw you. Why? You know, so we get through this level pretty fast when we don't have to, play a crappy berserker. You know what? I have to jump. That's also why. 19,000. When it's not an air combo... what you call it? Air combo finisher with the battle cry. There we go. I remember talking about before. I definitely looked it up after I did the first episode. And there was a Grendel 2 hoax, and Grendel 2 was not confirmed to exist. This guy said he was purple. There are still pictures on the internet if you actually look for it. And he said he dropped, like, really good guns or something. Wow! No! Give me the stupid critical hit. I don't want to deal with these! They hate the stupid dudes. Stop sending them at me. It's annoying because it's not like a set amount of them. He just keeps doing it until you take his health down to a certain point. You have to keep shooting him in the face. Yeah, with Smite, it's... we lose so many games to the same thing, and that's what frustrates me. I don't care that we lost. Especially if we get whooped. It's actually the easiest to digest if we get completely smashed, because it's like, oh, well, we just... oh, I should have. I wasn't even paying attention. I should have hit him in the face. Oh, I hate these. Oh, I almost got the 100. Alright. So, I mean, I almost got that high. So, you guys will probably believe me. Hopefully, you believe me that I can break 100,000 or whatever. So, yeah. But yeah, they lose to the same things over and over where it's like. You just, what is it? You get people dying to bad engages, not engaging correctly. People not playing their characters correctly. People not building their characters correctly. You know, people on our team will pick... like, they'll pick Hell. She's a healer slash damage mage or whatever. And she's one of the top 5 characters in the entire game because she's really strong, really broken at almost any level in the game. And we'll have people pick Hell, and they won't, they're not quick, because she has, like, the light side and the dark side, and the dark side's the one that does damage, the light side's the one that heals. They'll, like, they don't use the cleanse properly, they don't do the damage properly, and they don't switch between them quick enough, and they don't know when to be in which form or whatever. And it just, it kind of sucks. That's like, you're playing such a good character, and you're not quick enough, so you're not maximizing it, and that's part of the reason we're losing. Or they'll play assassins and go, like, 0-12 or something like that, and it's like, you're not playing correctly. And it sucks to keep watching it happen. And you want to say something, and it's like, half the time I do say stuff, like, yeah, you should be doing this, or try doing this, but not in an asshole kind of way. And the improvements still don't happen. It's kind of like in one ear and out the other. So now, usually when I play with my friends or whatever, I let them pick what they want, and then I just pick something that I want. I don't really do any more try hard. And I'll try and, like, call some shots during the match, but if we're losing really hard, I'll just stop calling shots, I'll just not care anymore. Which I know sounds kind of salty, and it's really to avoid getting salty. So, that's kind of interesting. Anyway, that's it for this one. Next time, probably Cyberspace. And if no one watches Cyberspace, I wouldn't blame you, honestly. It's going to be me running around and just popping stuff. I don't even, like, the thing is, I don't even want to do it because there's no point to doing it for my character, because I don't need the gear. Maybe I'll do it on the Berserker. No, it doesn't need health then. It's just this huge place for loot spires, and loot spires are not where you get the best items. So that's kind of why it sucks. But it's cool to see the whole place, because they put a lot of work into it or whatever, but yeah. Anyway, next time probably Cyberspace, and I'll do my best to make it interesting. I don't know if I'll slice in some dank memes or just talk a bunch of shit or something. I have no clue, but yeah, look forward to all that. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later.